Hi, this is second lecture I'm doing on the Christian responses to the ecological crisis. In fact, I did this lecture in Fireflies Center in Bangalore on the 4th of February 2017. Pope Francis, he provides a new theological basis for environmental action in his recent encyclical called Laudato Si. Be praised to you, Lord. That is the translation, in which Pope Francis is talking about ecology, environment, ecosystem, biosphere, all those ecological terms. Church is talking about ecology and environment for the first time in full length, even before Pope Benedict XVI in Caritas in Veritate, in the chapter 4, he talks about it. The whole chapter is dedicated for caring of environment, but this encyclical Laudato Si, it's full of it. It has 246 paragraphs. It's a lengthy document. Pope Francis writes so beautifully. Pope Francis says that we should learn from ecology and ecosystems. So far, we have been learning from the Bible, and we have learned from other disciplines and from our ancestors, religious leaders. All these people were teaching. I mean, all the teachings were human origin. But this time he gives a new insight. I think for the past maybe 4 million years, that's what humans age. The Homo sapiens appeared probably 250,000 years ago, but as a species, human, we have been living 4 million years, that is 40 lakhs of years. So, only for the past 10,000 years, humans are known for their own activity, which is not benevolent. Actually, humans earn the name exploiters, insurgents. All other species, they live according to the laws of Mother Earth, but only one species is insurgent, not living according to the laws of nature. So, consequently, the human species is facing their own extinction. Scientists call it the sixth mass extinction. It's about human species. For the past 4.5 billion years, there have been five great mass extinctions. Happened 50 million years ago, named as Devonian mass extinction. Comes then 350 million years almost, it's called Devonian mass extinction. The third one is Permian, 250 million years, and then Triassic mass extinction, that is 200 million. The fifth one was 65 million years ago, the Cretaceous mass extinction, or KT extinction. So now, after 65 million years, we are facing another great mass extinction. It's about human species. Before, there were dinosaurs or placoderms or trilobites. They went out of existence, but now human species is going to go out of existence. The difference between them and us, dinosaurs, they ruled the earth almost 180 million years. Almost the entire time of Mesozoic era, which comprises from 200 million to 65 million years. So, Triassic started 200 million, okay? Then came Jurassic, and then came Cretaceous. This is the three periods in Mesozoic era. All those species existed and disappeared over millions of years. Dinosaurs, as I told you, 180 million years, they ruled the earth and they disappeared. Placoderms, probably almost 180 million years, another 80 million. And the trilobites, almost, they existed 100 million years and they disappeared. So all these species, they lived their full life on planet Earth and they disappeared. But humans, only 4 million years. You tell me, dinosaurs 180 million, placoderms 180 million, and trilobites 100 million, and you tell me, humans only 4 million years. So I think we held a very short amount of time and we are facing extinction. In other words, only Homo sapiens is the failure project of the earth. It's a failure. Mother Nature is very much disappointed because humans, they didn't live long enough like other creatures. So Pope Francis is telling, if they lived for 180 million years, I think they must have been doing something right, isn't it? Something good, something benevolent, something sustainable. So our disappearance, the sixth mass extinction, if we are disappearing so fast, within 4 million years, that means we are doing something wrong, not sustainable, not appropriate. That's a brilliant analysis from Pope Francis. So he's trying to tell us that we need to learn from ecology and ecosystems, because they do it right all the time. And that is wisdom. Learn from nature. All wisdom comes from nature, isn't it? So Pope Francis is right when he says, learn from nature. Probably instinct he's talking about. Our human brain, the neocortex, evolved probably 150,000 years ago. And we call it the triple brain, the reptilian brain, the mammalian brain, and the neocortex. That is, this is the latest evolved brain in the front, neocortex, the left hemisphere, the right hemisphere. So this is what neocortex is all about. So we value human brain and the capacity to reason and cognition, capacity to make decisions, choosing right between wrong. All these capabilities come with neocortex. So unfortunately, we put so much emphasis on this part of the brain, and we have forgotten the greatest history of instincts. All other creatures, they don't follow neocortex, they don't have it anyway. They all relied on only one system called instinct. So when you compare instinct with reason, instinct has long history and a successful history. Things didn't go wrong when species followed instinct. Right now, I think we goof up because of neocortex and the arrogance which comes along with that. And we think we can rule planet Earth through our human brain. But we have learned a hard lesson that is not true. Mostly, human species is known to learn hard way. Cognition, reason, it's all hard way we learn. But instinct is an easy way. Just follow your heart, follow your instinct and do things. Most of them, we do it right. Hard way doing is relying on your own reasoning. We end up in practical relativism, we end up in anthropocentrism, we end up in other philosophies of esteeming our own species, the beauty of our species. All those dangers are involved when you follow your new cortex. But when instinct, nothing is involved, you do it right. That is what other creatures are doing for the past 4.5 billion years, isn't it? They seem to be doing right. So Pope Francis is not telling you explicitly, but he implies this insight. And it's better to rely on instinct as well. Reason is okay. Cognition is good. That is what it's all about, human species. But at the same time, we should give space to instinct. Follow your heart. Follow your consciousness. So combining these two and balancing both, that is the ability. That is the greatest power of Homo sapiens. So Pope Francis says, learn from ecosystems, learn from creatures, learn from animals and plants, how they do it, how they produce food, how they consume, how they recycle. All those lessons in an ecosystem, only three: producers, consumers, decomposers. Also in human ecosystem, the same thing. Some produce, some consume, some decompose. But we are not focusing on the wisdom of nature, but we are focusing on the wisdom of the human brain, which is a product of nature. Better we go to the source. Source is nature. So that is where lies the wisdom. Jesus recognizes that. When he teaches, learn from nature, learn from snakes, be prudent like snakes, he says. Learn from the doves, be innocent like doves. Learn from the fig tree, from the trees you learn. Foxes, look at the foxes, learn from them. Look at the birds of the air, learn from them. Look at the lilies of the field, learn from them. Look at the fishes in the lakes, learn from them. So Jesus talks about learning from Mother Nature. Even in Old Testament, the book of Job, chapter 12, verse 7, 8, 9, they state the similar experience, learning from nature. Job says, learn from the birds, learn from the fishes of the sea, and listen to nature, and they will tell you who created them. Wisdom comes. They all say God created us. That is the wisdom. So I think nature has the ability to teach to his children, especially the lost born Homo sapiens. And we deny that. We don't want to learn from nature. We want to learn from our own human resources. That's why we goof up. So Pope Francis simply telling, come on, do as creatures do. Follow ecosystems, how they efficiently do for the past 4.5 billion years. Animals, maybe 600 million years, they do it right. They are still existing today. Fish evolved almost 600 million years ago. Even today we find fish in the ocean because they are doing something right. Snakes, they are doing something right because even today they exist. They evolved some 215 million years ago. Their scientific name is diapsids. Diapsids is a lineage of reptiles we call snakes. they deviated from iguanas, crocodiles, and dinosaurs, diapsids. Even our cows and goat and cattle and chicken, what we want to eat, all of them, isn't it? But they are here to teach us. We misunderstood that. Stop learning from them, we are eating them. That's a mistake because of neocortex. The instinct would have taught you, no, don't eat them. Learn from them. We would have been a better and a smarter species. We are known as Homo sapiens, it's a misnomer. That is not appropriate name for our species. Homo sapiens means all-knowing man. What do we know all? We don't know all, but still we use that term to describe our own species. So I think we need humility, simplicity. As St. Francis of Assisi has put it, humility, simplicity is the attributes. They should be the attributes for Homo sapiens, but we don't have them yet. Not yet. We will become. I think we are very closer to them, humility and simplicity. Pope Francis in Laudato Si, paragraph number 117, he talks about our human activity. And instead of becoming humble and simple, what we are doing right now, the opposite thing, arrogance, authority, plunder, domination. So he points out so beautifully, actually he quotes from Saint Pope John Paul II from Centesimus Annus. So Pope Francis in Laudato Si, in paragraph number 117, writes as follows. Once the human being declares independence from reality and behaves with absolute dominion, the very foundations of our life begin to crumble. For instead of carrying out his role as a co-operator with God in the work of creation, man sets himself up in place of God and thus ends up provoking a rebellion on the part of nature. Such a beautiful quote. Our role should be the co-operator, steward, protector. But instead of that, we want to take the position of God Himself. Now there is no place for God. We removed God, and man declares himself as God. And he provokes a rebellion on the part of nature, abusing animals and plundering resources, polluting the waters and air. So it's an absolute dominion. It's not helping other creatures. Actually, our behavior hurts other parts of the natural world. In the place of God, we reposition ourselves. One example I want to give you is mountain. Look at the mountains. They are so beautiful. They are built by God Himself. It is the architect of the Creator God. Such a beautiful Himalayas. Alps, Andean mountains in America, South America. All those great mountains. In India, Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats. They are architects created by God Himself. But man looks at them and he thinks, God didn't create them well. His architecture is useless. There is nothing beautiful. So probably we take those mountains and we need to create our own architecture. So you reduce the mountain into rubble, gravel, stone. You quarry the whole mountain and you built a puny little temple or a church or other structures. And you call it beautiful. Sometimes man thinks we need to perfect God's creation. That is a folly. That's a delusion. God's creation doesn't need any upgrade, doesn't need any further perfection because they are perfect anyway. He doesn't need human hands to go and perfect them. No, he has done. Can you build a temple like Himalayas or a church like Himalayas? Can you build a cathedral like rainforest? They are green cathedrals. In fact, our building of our own human cathedrals, it comes from the rainforest model. All those branches, they come and cover like a basilica or a cathedral. They come like that. So human just cut and paste. We are good in cut and pasting. In that process, we ruin. You take gravel and stone from the mountain, that mountain disappears. The greatest wonder, architecture disappeared. We lost it forever. So we need to focus on God's wisdom, sovereignty, and wisdom, and just express awe and wonder. We kneel down and praise God and thank God. St. Francis Assisi, when he was looking at the natural world, he didn't look natural world as an element of resource to be hammered, to be transformed, as we do today. When we look at a mountain or a forest, we want to use it and hammer it, cut it, scrape it. We want to see an object of exploitation. We want to take it and do something about it. That is what all the contractors in India, we do that. When you look at a mountain, we see it as an economic or a material wealth to be transformed into something else. Want to make money and profit, that's it. Our human mind today in the 21st century, we see everything as the material to be put in the factory and produce into something and distribute and sell them in the market. But when Francis Assisi looked at the natural world, he looked it for intrinsic value. We look natural world as an instrumental value, all created for human use and abuse. But Francis looked at intrinsic worth. He looked the natural world for its beauty, awe and splendor, but also the role they play to keep up the balance in the natural world. One creature, if you destroy, you are destroying the whole ecosystem. So he sees as God's wisdom and beauty and sovereignty. And he doesn't see it as a material wealth, he sees it as a spiritual wealth, a wealth to be communed with, a wealth to be celebrated. And he bursts into song and dance. He becomes a mystic and he thanks God and he praises God. So the human resources, the spirituality bubbles up. It becomes like a ripples. That is what the canticle of the creatures is all about, where he calls brother sun, sister moon, brother wind, sister water, mother, sister earth, brother fire, brother wolf, sister lamp, sister death. This is the response you get when you look at the natural world. This is a normal response. The 21st century humans, that is dysfunctional response. It's a dysfunctionality. That is what the spirituality is all about. So Pope Francis talks about the business as usual model and the integral ecology model, he calls it, in the chapter 4 of Laudato Si. Business as usual model, we see the natural world as resource to be used and consumed and sold in the market. Business as usual. Integral ecology model sees for intrinsic value. You see it as a masterpiece of God himself, where God is immanent. He is present. It's a manifestation. Mountain is a manifestation of God. Oceans, forest, manifestation of God himself. So integral ecology model, we are all together, God, humans, creation. There is no Cartesian dualism. Actually, business as usual model was perpetrated by Cartesian dualism. Cartesian dualism forced us to see economy and society more important than ecology. It separated economy, separate ecology out there, society out there. Hence, society and economy was progressing at the destruction of ecology and environment. So because we are separated in Cartesian dualism, so we saw environment and ecology outside of us, so we can destroy them in order to progress and develop. So that's how we ended up business as usual model. But Pope Francis says that these three things are integral, not separate, not separate. So business as usual model, we need to say goodbye and we need to come to integral ecology, where everything has value. And so far, we have seen environment ecology outside of us. We valued economy and society, humans. Economy can give benefit. Society can benefit from economy. So, society endeared economy, but kept ecology and environment out, a resource to be used. But Pope Francis writes as follows in paragraph number 139 in Laudato Si. We are faced not with two separate crises, one environmental and the other social, but rather with one complex crisis, which is both social and environmental. So there is no Cartesian dualism, it is integral. Also, economy, so far, in business as usual, the economy was valued by humans. Of course, society is benefiting from economy, but not all parts of society. Only 1 or 2 billion people, other 5 billion people condemned to misery and poverty. So, economy was used only to some sectors of the powerful people. So, not entire society benefited from it. So again, Cartesian dualism. So the economy and society joined hands together and they have seen environment and ecology outside of us. So let us plunder them, take them, because they are outside anyway. They didn't understood that by destroying ecology and the environment, we are destroying ourselves because we are connected. We are not together. Because Cartesian dualism depicted everything as separate entity. But in integral ecology model, it's not so. It's all together. By destroying ecology and environment, you can ruin your economy and your society as well. Even that rich 1 or 2 billion people I'm talking about, you can ruin your future, your children's future. That is precise. So Pope Francis writes on economic ecology, the paragraph number 141 of Laudato Si, as follows. An economic ecology capable of appealing to a broader vision of reality. The protection of the environment is in fact an integral part of the development process and cannot be considered in isolation from it. And Pope Francis also talks about social ecology, where we should include all the 7 billion people today. Not only 2 billion people benefiting in social ecology, they become rich people, they are powerful. In the past, they were branded like First World, Second World, Third World, Fourth World. But today, high economic growth, medium economic growth, low economic growth, all those terminologies. Always there is not an egalitarian existence, there is hierarchy. There is discrimination. So Pope Francis says we should include, that is also integral ecology. Social ecology means you include 7 billion when you talk about progress and development. Don't fragment like Cartesian dualism. Okay, only 2 billion are worthy of development and the other 5 billion should be condemned. No, that's not right. So Pope Francis writes as follows in the paragraph number 142 of Laudato Si. Social ecology is necessarily institutional and gradually extends to the whole of society, from the primary social group, the family, to the wider local, national, and international communities, from family, from individual, all the way to the population of 7 billion. Within each social stratum, and between them, institutions develop to regulate human relationships. Anything which weakens those institutions has negative consequences, such as injustice, violence, and loss of freedom. Laudato Si, 142. 100% I agree with Pope Francis. The injustice, the violence today perpetrated in the world is the result of not being integral as 7 billion people. When people become rich, one sector naturally, other people, they will ask why we are not humans, we are not included in the developmental processes. How come only you are rich and you are the first world and you are high economic growth and you are American and African. African also has a right to develop. We are all human persons, we are created. The image of God, we celebrate in the Bible. Forget about image of God, we are have the same genes. We are egalitarians. Nobody has more genes than the other. Americans, they don't have more genes than Africans. Indians, they don't have more genes than Pakistanis. Everybody has the same biological makeup. And Pope Francis talks about cultural ecology. We should integrate cultures. In India, different cultures. There is unity in diversity in India. Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Hindi, Sikh, Parsi, different people, but everybody has their own identity, their own way of eating, dressing, speaking, behaving. So all these cultures should be integrated. All the wisdom existing in Buddhist culture should be brought onto the table and that should be used for the preservation of nature. Different religions also include here, different religious faith. Everything should be brought forward for the benefit of ecology and environment. Pope Francis writes so beautifully, very powerful words. I'm going to read Laudato Si, paragraph number 145. The disappearance of a culture, for example, today in India, we talk about culture, but it's very we end up in conflict. The Sanskrit, the Bhagavad Gita, yoga, all these are cultural wealth of India. We need to protect them and value them, and we should celebrate them, not to denounce them. So Pope Francis is very clear in his vision, and our bishops should read this document, and also the government officials should read this document in order to find balance in our approach. Laudato Si, 145 paragraph, states as follows: the disappearance of a culture can be just as serious or even more serious than the disappearance of a species of a plant or an animal. If they disappear, they will never come back. Dinosaurs disappeared 65 million years ago. Can you bring the dinosaur back? Can you bring placoderms back? Can you bring trilobites back? No, you can't do that. So once we lose this spiritual and cultural patrimony of our own Indian culture or any other culture for that matter, they won't come back. So we need to protect everything in a culture. Pope Francis also talks about the tribal people, those who live in tribal areas, the land, the water, the relationship what they have with the natural environment and the ecology. He writes in Laudato Si, paragraph number 146, as follows: for them, indigenous people, land is not a commodity, but rather a gift from God and from their ancestors who rest there, a sacred space with which they need to interact if they are to maintain their identity and values. Brilliant writing. Then Pope Francis plunges into human ecology. Human ecology, simply I can define our relationship with nature, the human species' relationship with nature. As we have ecosystems like taiga, tundra, savanna, chaparral, tropical rainforest, mountains, oceans, these are all ecosystems. The so human community also is a separate ecosystem. All those ecosystems, they learn to cooperate in a web of relationship. One ecosystem complements the other. It doesn't dominate the other. That is a secret you have to learn from ecosystem and ecology. There is no hierarchy there. Everything is egalitarian. Everybody does their job perfect in order to maintain the equilibrium or the balance of climate or an ecosystem. So in the same way, every ecosystem has their own resources, minerals, water, climate, so and so forth. So in the same way, we also have our own resources in human ecosystem. The word is human ecology, that's what Pope uses. We have so much inside of us. We have got empathy, we have got compassion, we have got mercy, we have got tolerance, we have got generosity, we have got the quality to say enough. And those are our resources. And also we have faith, hope and charity. That is human ecology, that is our inner resources. And also we have values. We have bioethics, we have got moral conduct, and we have our own benevolent philosophies and spiritualities. And our human species is known for its altruism. We take care of others. Only humans can do that. So, these are all inner resources. Also, God is within us. God is our own resource. In other words, in an inner dimension, the image of God is feasible. It may be right 100% in the inner dimension. Outer dimension, We can never become gods, but we can become like gods. So that is the inner dimension where we have resources. So, in other words, human ecology simply means you dig out, in the integral ecology model, you dig out your resources from within, like compassion, empathy, and give to nature. So far we have been plundering. We thought we were swayed, and our delusion is that resources are available in planet Earth: gold, silver, iron ore, fossil fuel, coal, all those stuff. We were swayed and we were misled that they are out and we have to take, and take. But now Pope Francis telling, stop taking, stop plundering the earth and start digging within you. You drill pipe inside and you bring out your extraordinary resources and give to Mother Nature. That is how you find balance between humans and ecology. So Pope Francis writes in Laudato Si, paragraph number 148, as follows. At times, a commendable human ecology is practiced by the poor despite numerous hardships. The feeling of asphyxiation brought on by densely populated residential areas, limitations of the environment are compensated for in the interior of each person who feels held within a network of solidarity and belonging. He talks about humans, poor people. They lost everything, but humans can compensate from their own resources from within, showing love and concern for them, showing mercy for them. That is what he writes. Humans can compensate. Even ecological crisis can be compensated, and we can solve the problem of ecological crisis by digging deep within each and every person. There are 7 billion planets, I can put it. Each person is a planet full of resources, and you can dig from you and take it and give to Mother Earth. It's already plundered, and give to poor people, those who are sidelined and oppressed. And Pope Francis continues in Laudato Si, paragraph number 155, human ecology also implies another profound reality, the relationship between human life and the moral law, which is inscribed in our nature and is necessary for the creation of a more dignified environment. Actually, it is a profound reality. Pope Francis is calling to the inner, the power of righteousness. Pope Francis says that the degradation of our ethics is the reflection of ecological crisis. There is no righteousness. We didn't give importance to the righteousness. In other words, the kingdom of God. Seek ye the kingdom of God and its righteousness, everything will be added to you. That's what Jesus says in Matthew chapter 6, 33. That's a beautiful statement. And if you have righteousness, if you have ethics, if you have values, I think we can create a better world. I think the erosion of value systems and righteousness, and we don't have any more consciousness, in other words, and that is what the reflection of the ecological crisis and the degradation of the environment and the ecology. So that is absolutely right, 100% Pope Francis. I give credit to him. So I think we need to restore and refine and reconstruct value system and bioethics on which we can embark on a new path of sustainable development. And thank you, and God bless, and goodbye.